let's discuss that activity part, the table given to you for matching the expressions which are used in the text with their meanings. On page 17, there is a table given. Yes, I would like you to raise your hands for the answers. Those who have not got the turn in the morning also, please raise your hands quickly. Madhav Kapoor. Madhav Kapoor or Mankirat Kaur, 47 and 34 roll number. Please quickly unmute yourself. Madhav or Mankirat, Gunish from 10th Blue, 32. Beta, unmute yourself and solve the exercise. Yes. Who's yes, going ma'am. To do? Who's going to do? Please. Sushant is raising hand. Beta, Gunish. Yes, Gunish, beta. Start.
My first question.
Questions, beta, we have already discussed. We are going to discuss the exercises given in your book. And in that, on page 17, there is an activity. You can see on the screen. An activity given on page 17, which I told you in the very beginning when we started the chapter, that we will discuss it at the end of the chapter, because these are the expressions which are used in the chapter. Accordingly, the meanings are given. Match these expressions with the meanings given in column B.
Rainbow gathering of different colors and nations.
Yes.
Column B mein, a beautiful coming together of various people like the colors in a rainbow.
Yes, first one, a beautiful coming together of various peoples like the colors in a rainbow. Yes, second one.
The seat of white supremacy. B column mein, the center of racial superiority.
Yes, the center of racial superiority. Superior samajhte the wo on the basis of the race. Next, third one.
Be overwhelmed with the sense of history. The half secret life, like a life lived in fading light between sunlight and sunset and darkness.
No. Be overwhelmed with a sense of history. Kya padha tha humne? Ki Nelson Mandela apni history ko yaad karke overwhelmed hota. Overwhelmed hota extreme feeling of happiness. The last option given in column B, remembering and understanding all the past events that have led up to the moment. Is mauke ko lane ke liye jo past events the, un sabko wo yaad kar raha hai, unko samajhne ki koshish kar raha hai. That it is all due to those past events and those events which had happened in the past when he remembered about the sacrifices of the great leaders, his companions, who had struggled for the freedom. Clear? Yes, next, fourth one. Read the fourth option, beta. Yes, Sushant, clear, please complete beta rest of the sentences.
Yes, ma'am. Fourth, the silence that defies the imagination. A great ability almost unimaginable to be changed by suffering, not losing goodness or courage.
Yes, fourth. Resilience that defies the imagination means a great ability almost unimaginable, jisko aap imagine bhi nahi kar sakte ho, to remain unchained by suffering, not losing hope, goodness or courage. Suffering ki bavjood bhi jab aap apni ability ko nahi khote ho, that is resilience. Okay, next.
A glimmer of humanity, a sign of human feeling, goodness, kindness, pity, justice, etc.
Yes, a sign of human feelings. What the human feelings? Goodness, kindness, pity, justice. These are all the human qualities, good qualities, which when one person possesses, that person is known as following the humanity, working for the humanity. Yes.
Next. A twilight existence, a half secret life, like a life lived in the fading light between sunset and darkness.
Yes, a half secret life, like a life lived in the fading light between sunset and darkness. Okay, now coming to the next part, come to the back exercise given after the questions. On page 24, thinking about the language. There are nouns in the text. Please try to understand. There are nouns in the text, formation, government. These words are used as nouns, which are formed from the corresponding verbs, form or govern. These are verbs. Form, verb hai, jisse noun bana hua hai, formation. Govern is a noun, a verb from which we have government as the noun. By suffixing ation or ment, iske sath hum suffixes add karte hain, or suffixes or prefixes. You might have heard the name. Aap Hindi Punjabi mein karte ho na, agetar or pichetar. The same thing is used here in English, suffixes and prefixes. So yahan par suffixes add kiye gaye hain. And accordingly, the noun is made from the verb. There may be change in the spellings of some verbs or noun pairs, such as rebel. Rebel se kya bana hua hai? Rebellion. Constitute se constitution. So these are the nouns which are made from the verbs by adding suffixes. Now there is a list in the chapter. You can find out the verbs and the nouns from the chapter. Make a list of such pairs of nouns and verbs in the text. The first two they have given, rebel verb hai, usse rebellion noun hai, constitute noun a verb hai, and the constitution is the noun from that. Can you find out any other verb in the sentence through which the nouns are used in the sentence? Yes, Devishi. Devishi Gera, please unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, noun form obligation and verb form oblige.
Oblige, obligation, yes.
Noun form oppression and verb oppress.
Oppress, oppression, yes.
Discrimination.
Write in proper column. Verb ko verb ke column mein likhna hai aur noun ko noun ke column mein likhna hai. Oppress is the verb, oppression is the noun, yes.
Noun form discrimination and verb discriminate.
Yes, discrimination noun, and from that verb is discriminate. One more.
Ma'am, verb form is free and noun form is freedom.
Yes, verb form is free. Free bhi hota hai aur freed bhi hota hai iski verb form. Theek hai?
Ma'am, discrimination, discriminate.
That is done. Discrimination is done. You can write inauguration. Inaugurate, inauguration ceremony पढ़ रहे हैं ना? Inauguration, inaugurate.
Deprivation and deprivate.
Yes.
Deprivation and deprive.
Yes, deprivation and deprive. So imagine, I think it is clear to you. You can find out the nouns from the chapter, and then you can write the verb for that accordingly. This is formation of nouns from the verbs. Coming to the next exercise. Now you are given a paragraph in which they have given you verb in the bracket, and accordingly you will make the noun of that verb and fill in the blank. Clear? There is one paragraph given to you. In that paragraph they have given you one verb in the bracket, and accordingly you will change that verb into noun and then fill in the blank. Okay, Malvika. Yes, Malvika beta, please unmute yourself.
Ma'am, Martin Luther King's contribution.
Yes, Martin Luther King's contribution
to our history as an outstanding leader began when He came to the assistance of Rosa Parks. Assistance.
T-A-N-C-E. Please check the spellings. Okay. Yes. Assistance of
Rosa Parks, a seamstress who refused to give up her seat on a bus to white passenger.
Yes.
In those days, American blacks were confined to positions of second-class citizenship by restrictive laws and customs. To break these laws would mean subjugation.
Yes, and subjugation. Now please check the spellings. End wala E kat jayega. T-I-O-N. Subjugation. E kat jayega. Okay. Yes, laws would mean subjugation and
humiliation.
Humiliation. Again, E will be deleted. H-U-M-I-L-I-A-T-I-O-N. Humiliation. Yes.
By the police and the legal system, beatings, imprisonment, and
yes,
sometimes
imprisonment. Imprisonment. Meant add kar doge imprison ke saath. Yes.
And sometimes death awaited those who defied the system.
Yes.
Martin Luther King tactics of protest involved non-violent resistance to racial injustice.
Non-violent resistance. A-N-C-E. End mein kya add karna humge? A-N-C-E. Clear? Non-violent resistance to racial injustice. Clear? So in this, all the words given to you in the bracket were verbs and you have changed into nouns. Now coming to the next part, that is about the definite article with names. You have discussed the determiners. And in the determiners, we have already discussed about the articles, that there is a definite article, the, which is used. A, an, or, and the. The is the definite article. But what they are telling you, note down something in detail about that particular article. They say, you know that the definite article, the, is not normally used before proper nouns. Ki proper noun, agar humare paas hai, hum uske aage the nahi kehte, hum ye nahi kehte. The Varun, the Arun, the Gandhi, ऐसा नहीं बोलते हैं ना, किसी भी proper noun के आगे हम the article use नहीं करते हैं. Not do proper nouns usually occur in the plural, और ना ही हमने कभी किसी proper noun को plural form में देखा है. We do not say the Nelson Mandela. Nelson Mandela नाम है, proper noun है, तो इसके आगे हम the नहीं लगाते हैं. और ना ही हम ऐसा कहते हैं Nelson Mandela's. S नहीं लगाते हैं इसके पीछे, मतलब प्लूरल भी नहीं होता है. बट नाउ लुक एट दिस सेंटेंस फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट. लेकिन हमारी टेक्स्ट बुक में इस चैप्टर में उन्होंने यूज किया है, द लगाया है नाम के आगे भी और एस लगाया है, प्रॉपर नाउन के पीछे एस भी लगाया, मतलब उसको प्लूरल फॉर्म भी दी है. तो उसका क्या मतलब है व्हेन वी यूज दिस? सी द सेंटेंस गिवन. द डेकेड्स ऑफ ऑपरेशन एंड ब्रुटैलिटी प्रोड्यूस्ड द ऑलिवर टेम्बोस, द वॉल्टर सिसलर्स of our time. This is a line taken from your chapter. Used in this way with the and or in the plural, a proper noun carries a special meaning. देखिए उन्होंने क्या किया, Oliver Tambo's के आगे the लगाया हुआ है, Walter Sisler's के आगे the लगाया हुआ है, because these are the names, proper nouns हैं. According to rule in the definite article, we don't use the in front of the proper nouns, but they have used it. What does it mean? They say it has a special meaning. And what is that? For example, what do you think the names above mean? Kya meaning hai iska? Now choose the answers they have given. What is the right answer? For example, Oliver Tambo, Walter Sisler. Iska matlab koi examples hai unke bare mein, kyunki example di gayi hai. Or many other men like Oliver Tambo or Walt Sisler. Means many men of their type or kind whose names may not be as well known. Now I want one should answer about this. Which is the correct answer out of these two? A part or B part? Yes, Lavanya? Lavanya? Which is the correct answer out of these two? They have used the or S. Yes, B1. What they want to show us? that many other men like Oliver Tambos, Walter Sisler, मतलब ऐसे और बहुत से लोग, उनके नाम के आगे द लगाने का मतलब या एस लगाने का मतलब क्या है कि हम क्या कहना चाहते हैं कि ऐसे और बहुत से ग्रेट लीडर्स थे, मैनी मैन ऑफ देयर टाइप और काइंड, जो कि करेजियस थे, जिन्होंने सेक्रीफाइस करे, जिन्होंने स्ट्रगल करी, जिनके नाम जो है वो मेंशन नहीं किए जा रहे. क्लियर? नाउ दे से इफ यू चूज ऑप्शन बी देन योर आंसर इज करेक्ट. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट, दे हैव गिवन यू वन एक्सरसाइज बेस्ड ऑन द यूज ऑफ दिस आर्टिकल द इन फ्रंट ऑफ द प्रॉपर नाउन. Look at these sentences. They say here are some more examples of the used with the proper names. Now try to say what these sentences mean. In sentences ka kya matlab hai? Aapne ye batana hai after reading these sentences. Okay. Now I would like who has not got the turn, quickly raise your hands. Quickly raise your hands who would like to solve this exercise. Those who have not got the turn. Yes, Sumit. Sumit from 10 Blue, would you be able to? Sumit, beta,
yes, ma'am.
Quickly unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, read the sentence and give me the answer. What is the meaning of that? Using the article in front of the proper noun. Yes, read first sentence.
Mr. Singh regularly invites the Amitabh Bachchans and the Shah Rukh Khans to his parties.
क्या मतलब है इसका? जब वो proper noun के पीछे s add कर रहे हैं, उसको plural form दे रहे हैं, Amitabh Bachchans, Shah Rukh Khans, s add कर रहे हैं ना? जबकि हमारा rule क्या कहता है definite articles का, that we don't use s and we don't use the in front of the proper nouns. What does it mean then? क्या meaning convey करना चाहते हैं वो? Please explain. Yes, beta. We have seen the example.
It is conveying us the message of their family, the Bachchans and Khans.
Mr. Singh regularly invites the Amitabh Bachchans and the Shah Rukh Khans to his parties. क्या मतलब है कहने का? मतलब ऐसे बहुत से लोग क्या हैं, अमिताभ बच्चन और शाहरुख खान क्या हैं, सेलिब्रिटीज हैं, फिल्म एक्टर्स हैं, तो कहने का मतलब क्या है? That Mr. Singh regularly invites many people like these. कि ऐसे बहुत से लोगों को वो अपनी पार्टीज में बुलाते रहते हैं. समझ रहे हो? हमने ऊपर एग्जाम्पल करी ना, the Oliver Tambos, the Walter Sisler, क्या मतलब था? Many men of their type or kind, मतलब वैसे ही और बहुत से लोग. ठीक है, समझ रहे हो मीनिंग? Now coming to the second sentence, Drik Bajaj.
Second, many people think that Madhuri Dixit is the Madhubala of our times. This means that many people, it is believed that Madhuri Dixit is as great dancer as Madhubala was.
Yes, Madhubala belongs to the old time, purane time ki actress hai, aur Madhuri Dixit uske aage modern time ki hai. To wo kya keh rahe hain ki many people think that Madhuri Dixit is the Madhubala of our times, ki jo Madhubala ki qualities thi waisi hi qualities Madhuri Dixit mein thi. Theek hai, wo hamare time ki Madhuri Dixit thi, Madhubala ki tarah thi wo. Theek hai? That means many people of the same kind. This here you can note down the used in front of Madhubala, proper noun ke aage the used kiya hua hai. Clear? Coming to the third sentence. Yes, Divya. Yes, beta, complete the third sentence.
Third sentence. This means that history is history is not only the story of Alexanders, the Napoleons, and the Hitlers, but the ordinary people as well.
Yes.
This sentence means that history is not only the story of very big fighters and kings. It is also the history. It also has the stories of ordinary people.
Yes, great kings you can say, or the great historians you can say, great fighters you can say, because they are using the in front of these proper nouns, the Alexanders, the Napoleons, the Hitlers. समझ आ रहा है ना? कहने का मतलब क्या है कि ऐसे बहुत से और लोग. Clear? Now after this, there is again one exercise given to you. Match the italicized phrases in column A with the phrase nearest to the meaning in column B. And what is given to us here? First, look at the sentence in the text, which the phrase in column A occurs. क्या मीनिंग उसका दिया जा रहा है? जैसे फर्स्ट कॉलम में आई वॉज नॉट अनमाइंडफुल ऑफ द फैक्ट. इडियोमेटिक एक्सप्रेशंस हैं जिसको हम इडियम्स कहते हैं. आप हिंदी में मुहावरे लोकोक्तियां करते हो ना, दैट इज द सेम थिंग. इडियोमेटिक एक्सप्रेशन दिए गए हमें. क्या कहना चाहता है इसमें राइटर? जब वो फर्स्ट सेंटेंस यूज किया गया तो उसका मीनिंग क्या है? हु वुड आंसर? रिया चड्डा. यस बेटा, Riya Chadda, but I quickly complete this exercise. We are left with only 3 minutes.
I was not unmindful of the fact.
Mm-hmm. Three options are given. You have to choose one correct answer. What is the meaning of this expression given?
Second, when my comrade had not forgotten was the affair of the fact.
Just wait. Choose the answer from
the first option.
Yes, first one. Had not forgotten and was aware of the fact. Second.
When my comrades and I were pushed to our limits. Third option.
Yes, third option. Felt that we could not endure the sufferings any longer. Third one.
To reassure me and keep me going. Second option.
Second option. Yes, help me continue to live in the hope. In very difficult situations. And the last one?
The basic and honorable freedoms of earning my keeping, my keep, first option.
No, it is second option. Keeping what I earn. Keeping what I earn. So accordingly, these idiomatic expressions are also used in the chapter, which are giving you the meaning clearly. Now after this, there is one exercise given on page 27. Using some expressions, they have given you some expressions in the column box. You have to fill those in the blanks to complete the meanings according to your text. And then in the second part, they have given you the clauses in which one clause is completed and the second clause is incomplete, which you have to complete according to the text. Here, giving the contrast views, that is giving you the contrast views. Please solve these two exercises also. And tomorrow, we will start with the grammar part after finishing these two exercises. We'll have the revision of the tenses, which you have been doing since many years. But still, you need reminder. Okay? Yes, goodbye. Bye.